Yes, well, the volatility is extremely low today because of the impact of quantitative easing. And with the end of quantitative easing, we could very much expect the volatility to return to previous levels. And it's very likely that volatility will spike because just when there's less liquidity, volatility comes back. So in this respect, the way we are built with relatively conservative gross exposure and net exposure makes the fund well fitted for such a higher volatility environment. I think that every asset is expensive these days. It's very logical, the world has been flooded with liquidity because quantitative easing was here for so long. Now central banks are trying to remove liquidity, and we could see the price of assets normalize and revert to the mean. In this respect, in markets which are likely to be much more lateral, I think there's as much opportunities on the long and on the short side. And owning low strategies with low net exposure makes plenty of sense in this environment. The fund is a pan-European fund, so we invest in Europe. Before investing in countries, we invest in companies, okay? And in these countries, there are some companies which are very international, which are exporting, which are exposed to many, many other markets. And we have not, it, so this exposure to Italy, Spain, and Portugal doesn't necessarily reflect a view about these countries. They reflect a view about the companies we own in these countries. I would say also that particularly when it comes to Spain and to Portugal, it's definitely been a place where economic growth has been relatively strong in the past few years. I wouldn't say the same for Italy. It's voluntarily, this product is exposed to large and mid caps. That's part of the strategy. We don't exclude, and sometimes we are exposed to smaller caps, but as part of our risk criteria, one thing which matters a lot to us is the liquidity, okay? Being able to come to increase or to decrease our exposure to the stocks. So in this respect, small caps, which trades less than €10 million a day, we try to control our exposure to this segment. So we don't have really a target in terms of returns, okay? So the way I think about it is that my number one objective is to preserve capital as much as possible. It's very difficult to make any kind of promise when you work on the equity market, but being able to deliver capital protection like we've done in the past, our maximum drawdown has been 4%, and we've always recovered from that in the past. When the European stock market fell in many, many instances 20%, that's something which matters to us as an investor, because we are heavily invested into the fund, and that's also what our investors are expecting. When it comes to the second target of the fund, obviously, is to deliver more participation to the upside, obviously. It's been proven in the past that it's quite uncorrelated, in fact, to the performance of the market, okay? So the past few years, we've delivered something like what you say, it's been 2% per year. But you know, it's been in other years, more distant years, you know, we had much much stronger performance than that. So I would say that in this environment, you know, delivering 5% or more would be very satisfactory to us.